Hello everyone, this is Mohit, and today we are going to see how we create a responsive website on 12 platform. We go on sales channel. Here is online store website. We click on this link and this will open a new tab where we can see if we have any previous application. We can see the list of all the application. As you can also see, if we are going to create a new application, then we here is a button called new application. Click on it. It will list down all the related themes and templates of website. So today we are going to create a website for a pizza restaurant. So we have to choose a suitable theme for website. So here we go. Down foodie Punjabi, and so I think this theme looks suitable. Online restaurant menu. So there is two button, view demo and select theme. If you want to see how your website will look something, then you can see the demo and select theme. So now I'm selecting this theme. I have selected restaurant menu theme. Okay. Here are some options like select theme, your website title. So website title is like the Pizza Hut website. We can change it if we want. And then we have to select application type like website or any app. So today we are going to create a website. So I have selected website, and sales channel is online portal. So we have selected online portal. Now we have to select our unique application name on 12 platform. So here is a suggestion, the Pizza Hub, which is the name. If we click enter or tab, it will show it if it's available or not. So the Pizza Hub is available. Now we just need to proceed. And here is the message. Your request is in queue. We will send you confirmation when it's done. Here you can see we got a default logo and so many other default settings. So once the website is ready, it hardly took 30 seconds. So then we will got a email on our register email ID. So once I go back, I will see that the new website which I have created right now, the pizzahub.12.com, is now ready. So to see the website, we can click on this link. This will open a new tab, and here we can see that we got a default website with all the default setting like all the logos and header menu options, phone number, email, all the buttons. So we can see that in this website, we can change the main text, buttons, logo, header option, and a lot of the things in this website. Even we can change this footer and social media icons. So now I will tell you how we can change the logo first. Then we need to go back on the web manager. Here we need to click on customize button. So this will load all the default settings. So first option here, we open this website setup. We can see all the listed options which show customization of website like general setting, header, home page, product detail page. So first we go on general setting. So in general setting, we can see select your logo. So now we are going to change logo button. Upload from device or select from media library. So as I have a logo in my media library, so I'm selecting logo from media library. So here we can see all the images we have in our album. Now I am going to choose this logo to make, this image to make logo on the website. Here we can see option select image. once I selected image, here you can see it's showing a preview of logo. Once I done save settings, go on website, refresh it. We can see we got a logo Pizza Hub now. Things like if we want to change the header options, like here is login, menu, operating hours. Let's say we go want to remove this opening hours from this website, then go back, click here, click on header. Here we can see menu, opening hours, about us. So let's say we want to remove this opening hours and wants to add some new option. Let's say menu two, let's say for menu new, for example. Then we will select the menu link from here. Once we have changed, save setting, go back on website, refresh it. We will see that opening hours is now gone and we got a new option of new menu. As we have selected menu for this link, we click on new menu. We will get a menu screen on this click. As we have already set up our inventory, so here's the list of all the inventory where we can see the complete menu with catalog on site. If we click on catalogs, then this will show the menu items as per catalog. So go back to on home screen. Now we can change this image, carousel image, this text, this short description. We go again back to web manager. Here we will go on home page settings. The feature text shows the Pizza Hub website, which you can see is also showing Pizza Hub website. So now we are changing it to some other text. And save settings. Go back to website, refresh it here. The fresh Pizza Hub and 20% on the first of the apply coupon pizza. If you want, I will show you how to change this carousel image. Go back to web manager. Here we can see that this image already showing in the image. I have selected two images for the carousel. Select image. Here it will show a preview. Homepage carousel image. As I can see, one and two images. Save settings. Go back on website. Refresh it. Now all the two images are updated. Other thing which we mainly want to change is the color combination of this website. To change this color, I'm not going to back on the web manager. Here is the option of web CSS. Let's click on this. As you can see, theme color is something brown. Now I'm changing and getting my color. Let's say I want to make it black, some grayish color. And the theme invert color is the light color combination, and I am making it white. Update CSS, go back, refresh. So now as we can see, that color which was brown last time is now black, and the yellow color of the text and fonts is now white. So once we load the website, we can see a black screen. If we want to change this color, then there is a splash screen color option. We can change it from black to, let's say, I will change it to some blue color. Go back, update. In the last option, there is a footer link. Click on this. We will see that there is a four columns and there are options about us, this. Go back on website. We see these options same here. So let's say add new option in support. So here is support. I will add a new option. Phone support and target option, let's say it's again contact us. Save it, refresh it. Go back to down. As I can see, this is phone support is appearing now here. Let's say we need to change this option which are coming, inquiry, phone number and all. So go back to home page, headers. Here we can see inquiry and phone number options. Reach us and the link will be /contact us. It's okay. Tell is once someone click on this link, this should open in mobile dial mode. Now let's save it. As you can see, there is some different number. Once I refresh it, it will show reach us and the other number. Moving back to the web pages. So here is three tabs, pages, blocks and partials. Pages is something which is like this about us. Once we create a page, we just need to give a slash and the page name. And here the content and the banner will appear. So first we will create a web page. Let's give a title to demo page. And this is web page. So select is the web page. And this is the main page. Now we add some text. We can change this font and size and all from here. I am going to make it bigger. Text align. I'm going to save it. Once I save it, click on this, edit. So here we got a link of this web page. The domain name of our website, the pizzahub.tor.com/demo page. If I copy this, go in website and paste it, this will open a new demo page. Here we can design whatever we want, means with HTML, pure CSS. If you are a technical person or if you have some knowledge of HTML, CSS, then you can go in this HTML tag where you can write your code, HTML code, and submit it. This will appear here. If you want to disable these headings, banner and all, we need to give in advance. Here we can see global banner, override global banner settings. Click on this. Now we need to show the banner, but we don't want to show the heading and we want to show description. If we want to override the image, we need to give new banner image URL. Go back to our portal. Where in operation, we can see manage album option. View album. This looks good. Click on original and this is good. Copy this URL Now go back to Web Manager tab and banner image URL, paste your URL here. Now it comes to give banner image height in percentage. So currently it's like 50%. I'm not going to give it 50% again. Let's say 40% and save it. Refresh the page. As you can see, banner image is changed, but we have hidden the heading and description, so nothing is coming up here. Go back to Web Manager, enable heading, update it. So go back to web pages. Here is three tabs. We have seen how to create pages. Let's create a blog. Blog is something which we want to show on our website. This is similar to web pages. Just the difference is it is categorized under blogs. Select blog. Give a name. Give some heading and just save it. Simple. Now we got a blog. My first blog. So as we can see, we will customize it later, but as we can see, this is blog. Go back to website setup, go in header, go down header links, add more link of blogs. Select target page as blogs. Save settings. Go back to website. Refresh it. So here is an option of blogs. Once we click on blogs, it will list down your blog. As we can see, there is no image, so it's not looking good. Go back to Web Manager. Web pages. Blogs. Let's give this blog and banner. So here it's called a page preview image. Go now, select a medium image. This looks good. Copy this, go to Web Manager and paste your preview URL. Update this page. Go back on website, refresh the page. You will see that your blog is now having a preview image. As I can see, what I have written is now here. As we have seen a lot of customization in a website, go back to the main thing like online ordering. Let's check the website on some cross browser like Firefox. Change it again back to takeaway. Done. So as you can see, here is 1, 2, 3, and 4 items in my cart. Subtotal is 20.87. Click on checkout, or you can see there is a cart option. So, but we are going to click on checkout. So here it's asking for login. So as I can see, my name is coming here. I have successfully logged in. Now click on checkout. So here is a setting which we have done that minimum order of $50 is required. So let's go back. We can change the setting later from our portal. I have increased the value to $54. Now check out. What I have selected is I can see here. So here is another option that someone can schedule their time of takeaway. So if it's ASAP or later, let's say I'm selecting it for later option. So I have selected for tomorrow 10 a.m. morning. If you want to restrict the order on a particular time, let's say it's 11:50 a.m. my time. So I want to check someone cannot place order before 12 p.m. Go back to the settings. Click on your web manager. Here is an option of online ordering timings. So currently we don't have any time constant. So let's put some time constant. Here is the option delivery, dine-in, takeaway. So currently we don't want to put any, we just want to restrict. We are just checking for takeaway orders. So let's say what day is today? It's Saturday. So go back on Saturday. Currently it's showing from 5 p.m. to 10:45. Let's make it order can be placed from 12 p.m. to this. Now save settings. There is another options, like if you completely want to off on Saturday, then just close it. If you want to make it open for 24 hours, then click on open for 24 hours. If you don't want to open for 24 hours, just off it and add your slots. Let's say first slot is 12 to 2 p.m. Then the time will go in 24 hour format. So this, and second slot is from 5 means 17.00 to 10. 10 is 22 p.m. Save settings. Now go back to the website. Let's say we go again on cart, refresh the page and check out. As we can see, we have changed the slot. We have changed the slot for Saturday from 12 to 2 p.m. and from 5 to 10 p.m. So it's showing sorry, unable to process your takeaway order. Please wait, we are about to open at 12 p.m. So currently it's 11:53 a.m. Go back on website setting, make it 11:55. Save it, go back to browser, go back to cart, refresh it. So there is another options like credit, debit card. Let's say I've selected cash and add comment if any. I don't want to add any comment, confirm. So here it's saying it will take approx 30 minutes to prepare food. This message can also be customized. Let's say I'm going to now okay and confirming order. Just wait. So this is another message. As we can see, something is ringing in my POS. So as you can also see that an order has placed, and in my POS, I am getting a notification. In a POS, I will get this notification whenever any online order place. So it's like accept order, reject order, dismiss. So I am clicking on view order. Click on more. We can see the customer name, email address, phone number, pickup address, and currently the order status is in progress. So update status to in progress. Once you update the status, an email will trigger to the customer notification that yes, the restaurant has accepted your order. They are working on it. Print request created means if you have your printer connected, then our print will create on your printer. And as I have changed the status to in progress, so it's showing that order history also. If you want to see invoice, then you can click on view invoice button. It will show the invoice of the order. So a customer will also get this screen where he can check, he she can check that what is the actual invoice of their order. They can check the details, suborder, total and all. if they want to view invoice, then click on view invoice, they will get the invoice also of this order. So this is some plain order. Now we want to give some coupon discount and offers on this order. So to create coupon, inside operation, here is manage coupons, create coupon. So let's say I am creating a coupon code. This is the name which you can give to your coupon code. So there is two type of coupon, percentage or fix. So percentage means it will give percentage discount as per your order. Fix is some fixed amount of. So we are giving a 10% discount. If we want to set minimum maximum redeem value, means how much someone can redeem. So let's say $20. So there is two other options. Check this box if coupon validity is subject to minimum orders. Means if you want to give some minimum order amount, then only this coupon will apply. Yes, I am going to give 10. If we are not going to give any coupon discount, then it will accept the discount with any minimum amount. There's some validation of this coupon code. Let's say I'm not editing it. Save this. So now Pizza 10 is applicable coupon code. Let's say copy this coupon code, and I'm now again going back to the website. I'm adding two items. Click on checkout again. We can change it from here also, but minimum order value is 50. So this we can also do from the website setup. If we don't want to put any restriction on the website minimum order display, then go back to web manager. Here we need to do something from advanced setting, in advanced edit. So here is the pure JSON code. If we have any technical knowledge, we can also update many things from this setting. Go to back to cart as 50 minimum order is required. I am updating the item. Now check out, 50% is done. You can show some coupon code upfront on the website. If it's valid, then it will apply it. So click on apply, as this is invalid coupon code, so it will not apply. Remove it and type the coupon we have created, pizza 10. Apply it. So it's saying 50. Yes, coupon code is applied with $50 value. I am now again adding one more item. Checkout. So as we can see, subtotal was $60, coupon discount is -6. I am again selecting cash and writing some instruction for the business. Save command and confirm. Okay. So as I am the admin of this business, in my POS, I can see that again I am getting a notification. So I am now clicking on accept order. So once you click on accept order, it will directly change your status to in progress. So if you click on accept order, you don't need to again click on in progress button. So once you accept the order, the customer will get a notification, yes, order is accepted by the business. So now if your order is ready in kitchen, you can update status to ready for pickup. Once you change the status, again, customer will get the notification that yes, my order is ready. Then he will arrive at your store and your restaurant and will collect the order. Here is some other options like collect payment. So let's say customer has selected cash as the payment option. Click on collect payment. Now the order is of $54. So payment is $54 and they are paying the amount in cash, select cash. Payment date is yes, current date. You can, if you accepting or updating the payment later, then you can change it. But I am updating right now, so there is no need to change. Confirm it. So this is now a paid order. You can see. So in pause, you can update the status to complete, or if you want to refund the payment, if you want to refund the payment, then you just need, you can click on refund payment and do other things also. Go back to the website and here we can see that in website, customer can also check my orders, means they can check their previous orders and what is the current status of the order. Click on this. I can get the details of my order as the payment was received in cash. So payment details is now showing $54 paid by cash on this time. I have made a comment, make pizza little spicy, which is also visible here. This comment will also appear on the POS site where customer can get this, that this customer won't make pizza little spicy, so they can modify the items or any instruction which you give, they can receive. So I think this is the complete whole processing with a minimal setup. And so as you can see in this complete time, it took only up to 5 to 10 minutes to create a website, and placing order is easy. Make your customers to place orders from your website and you will receive order and complete the process through 12 point of sale and 12 websites. Thank you, everyone.